Welcome. Now, till now, the world we saw, right, was a very simple world. The baby balls and the baby ants you created with code, they would be born with the same speed and leave the screen and go forever with the same speed. But the real world is a messy, messy place that almost never happens. So in fact, the real world and many times the computer world is super messy. Watch this. So have you watched F1 races or played GTA, GTA 5 or NFS? You see that constantly the speedometer is changing throughout the race, right? But nobody cares. Nobody cares that you went so fast somewhere in between in the race. What do we care about? Who finished first? Right? That's all we care about. Now, there are cases where this is true, right? Mostly. Watch this.
Away first time, good start from Bolt. Bolt leading a moment and going away. Gay trying to go with him and he's going, being dragged through to second place, but he's going to win it by 2 metres. 9.58, the world record's gone. That's more like it, sub 9.6.
What we just saw here was Usain Bolt's world record race, 100 metre race. He finished it in 9.58 seconds. Now clearly, he started at rest. Right, if you attach a speedometer to him, his speed is like increasing and then like reaching a peak, then decreasing. But do we care? We don't care. What do we care about? He finished the race first, right? The total distance he covered, 100 meters, and the total time he took, 9.58 seconds, faster than anybody else. So whenever this happens, right, when there's a lot of messiness, so if I ask you, what's his speed? You can't tell a simple answer, right? There's a lot of messiness. But what if we don't care about that messiness and we want to simplify the thing? Whenever we want to do that, we just try and imagine that messiness was not there. That's one of the things we do in physics. So what if I asked you a question? Imagine, just like instead of Usain Bolt being real, we created a cartoon Usain Bolt, who, like our baby balls and baby ants we created with code, right? Like them, he was just born on a skateboard right at the starting line. And he starts exactly at the time the race starts, but goes at the same speed throughout. Like, is born with that speed, goes all the way, and finishes the 100 meter race, cruising at the exact same time as the real Usain Bolt, just at one single speed. What would that speed be? Think about that question. Now that you've discussed this with your learning coach and team, what is my way of thinking about the answer? Let me give you my way. See, if Usain Bolt just was born on the starting line and had, like, you know, just a cruise control speed, he was on a motorized skateboard just going, what would he have, and he finished exactly the same time as the real Usain Bolt, how much distance did he cover? Right, 100 meters. How much time did he take? 9.58, the same as Usain Bolt. Then what's this question really asking? What should the speed be if that speed is not at all changing? That becomes like a really simple question, like I did in the previous episode, right? Like, I covered 100 meters in 9.58 seconds, but what is speed really? How much distance I cover in 1 second? So all I have to do, this is what division was invented for, all I have to do is take 100 meters, divide it by 9.58, and whatever number I get, that's the amount of distance this imaginary Usain Bolt would have covered, the skateboard Usain Bolt would have covered in 1 second. That's all I care about. And if you do that, the answer comes out to be about 10.22 meters per second. So doing this calculation is not the point. The point is knowing it's 100 divided by 9.58. And this quantity, right, this 10.22, actually whoever has this highest only is winning the race, right? Is this the speed at which real Usain Bolt ran? No, right? At some point he was faster than this. In the beginning he was actually at rest. He was definitely lower than this. But we don't care about all that. We just ask, hey, who won the race? Whoever had the highest, this cruise control speed, right? If you had done this for all the races, all the other people who were running, whoever had this highest number, that's all we care about. Now, because it's useful, whenever in physics something becomes useful, we go like, okay, fine, shall we just name it? And then we give it a name. Now, why is this useful? It simplifies our world, removes all the messiness, so we gave it a name, and the name happens to be average speed. What is average speed? When anybody tells you average speed, all you have to think about is, okay, it's the speed at which if you created that person or car or whatever it is, pluck, just comes there and goes at the same speed and finishes the same time, what would that speed be? That's average speed. Now, it turns out that Usain Bolt's average speed was 10.22 meters per second. Now, why is this interesting? When I got to know about it, I just realized that 10.22 meter per second, or 37 kilometers per hour, is basically him covering in every second one entire length of a bus in every single second. That's how he was running. If you just take the skateboard Usain Bolt, he'll be covering a bus length every single second. And in fact, Is that the highest speed Usain Bolt, real Usain Bolt reached? No. At his peak, between 60 meters and 80 meters, he was doing about 12 meters per second or 45 kilometers per hour. That's the fastest any human being has ever run in the history. Now I have another question for you. Imagine that you took an F1 racetrack or your GTA track, whichever it is, NFS. Took it. Typical F1 tracks are like, the races are about 300 kilometers. They do multiple circuits. Let's just take that entire track and stretch it out into one long 300 kilometer road. And the leader typically finishes the race somewhere around 90 minutes or 1.5 hours. But obviously the speed is changing constantly, as you saw. So imagine, the question I have for you is, imagine you didn't do all of that. You just started your car right at the start. You were born right over there, and maybe like Tesla or any of these cars, many cars now have cruise control. Do you know what cruise control is? You can just set the speed that you want the car to have constant. Just set it, and then you can just sleep in the car, and then this car can go and finish the race for you. Now, if you could just start the race, set it in cruise control mode, same speed, and finish it exactly at 90 minutes like the leader, what speed should you have? Think about that question. Now, what speed would that be? What's the distance you have to cover? 300 kilometers. And you need to take 1.5 hours, right? But what is speed really? Speed is just how much distance you need to cover in one unit of time, right? In this case, we can keep it as an hour. So in 1.5 hours, you have to cover 300 kilometers. So in 1 hour, how much should you cover? That's right, 200 kilometers per hour, 200 kilometers every hour. Now that's, what is this really? The speed at which you can just sleep in the car, by the way, it's a very high speed if you can think about it, right? You set the car to 200 kilometers per hour and you sleep. No matter what happens, finally you'll finish the race exactly at the same time as the other person who's done all kinds of crazy things. Now, what is the speed's other name? It's the average speed, right? Because what is average speed? No matter what formulae they make us remember in school or will make you remember in the future, it's just this. If I could just forget all the complexity, set my car on cruise control, and go at the same speed and finish at the same time, what speed would that be? Now, I'm emphasizing this again and again because either they'll teach you this formula, right? The average speed equals the total distance by the total time, and you have to mug this up. And they'll give you more and more complex formulae to remember. But you don't have to remember any of them as long as you understand this fundamental idea that what is average speed? It's just the speed that I have to imagine cruising in. It's the cruise speed. The moment you remember this, the moment you understand this, you don't have to remember anything else. You can infer everything else with logic. So we're going to throw at you in the next station some interesting questions that will help you prove to yourself that as long as you understand this, you don't need any formula. You can infer it just using logic.